Last month, Metropolitan Golf Club on Melbourne's famous Sandbelt played host to the first big event of the Aussie Summer of Golf, the Australian Masters. A return to the tournament meant more to Jarrod Lyle than most, as the 33-year-old's recovering after a second bout with leukemia. Jarrod sat down with Golfing World at the Masters to talk about his remarkable return to the game and give us the all-important update on how he's feeling.
Health's fine. We haven't had any issues at all, and couldn't be in a better spot. Well, the reason we came home from the States when we did was I had doctor's appointments, but they were changed, so I got to go and see them and have all my blood tests and all that kind of deal and see my doctor. So it's, but by all accounts, and I'm feeling fine by myself, so you know I feel like there's nothing wrong, and hopefully the doctors say that when I see them.
Lyle returned to professional golf 12 months ago at the 2013 edition of the Australian Masters. There was hardly a dry eye in the house as he stepped onto the first tee at Royal Melbourne last year, about to hit his first tournament shot in nearly 2 years.
I know how hard it was for me to get out there and play, so it's something I don't really want to look back on and look at, you know, how hard it was for me to hit that first tee shot and get out there. But you know, it was funny, I pulled my golf bag out this morning, yesterday morning, and pulled the yardage book out, and it was last year's yardage book. So, you know, I've sort of got that with me, that tiny little memory of last year with me. But, mate, it's nice to, you know, when I do look back on it, see how far I've come in 12 months. You know, I've won a couple of golf tournaments, but, you know, just to be able to get out there and play golf again was better than all those.
Jarrod has certainly come a long way since that memorable day in front of friends and family, and things are definitely looking up heading into 2015. The Lyle family have returned to America, and now he's working on regaining his PGA Tour playing privileges that were lost when his leukemia returned.
To go over to the States, you know, this year and catch up with all these guys that had, you know, sent messages and things, it was probably the most special thing, and I had to sort of you know, sit back after a while and realise that, you know, it's all well and good to say hello to people, but I'm there to play golf again. You know, it was hard to, you know, split the two things up.
Apart from the reception he received, the other big positive was his golf. He played two events in October to start the 2015 PGA Tour season and made the cut in both. Under the rules of his medical exemption, earning just over $280,000 in 20 starts, will see him retain his full status.
It was nice to go over there and play those golf tournaments, have that opportunity to play two of them and just sort of get a gauge on, you know, where I was at. Because I had a lot of questions about, you know, my golf game, whether it was still going to be good enough to contend with, you know, these 23-year-old kids that are, you know, muscly and fit and strong and hitting it miles. You know, that was enough for me to sort of sit back and go, you know what, those questions that I had about whether I was going to be good enough, they've been answered, and I know that I'm good enough to be over there and play well over there.
Family support has been a huge part of Jarrod's comeback, and he's making sure they're there for every step in 2015. Instead of spending endless hours waiting in airport lounges and chasing lost luggage, Jarrod, his wife Bryony, and daughter Lucy will be going on a road trip.
It's a nice way to do it. It's a slower way than flying everywhere, but you know, we get to see things that you wouldn't see in an aeroplane. So, you know, we travel around in a 45-foot motor coach. You know, we've got a good little system that we've figured out, and it's just a great way to do it. You meet so many nice people in these RV parks, and, you know, people are always nice and friendly, and if something happens, you can always ask someone for help, and they're more than willing to come and help you.
Jarrod is offering plenty of assistance of his own to those who are taking up the same battle with leukemia that he's now fought on two occasions. The knowledge that his story is providing inspiration to others is a situation which he still hasn't quite got used to.
That's something I struggle with every day. You know, I'm just a guy playing golf. You know, I'm good at one thing in life, and that's playing golf. You know, but I guess now I'm sort of coming to terms that, you know, with everything that I've been through in my life, you know, having leukemia as a 17-year-old, now as a 30-year-old, it's, you know, I just think about it and go, okay, well, you know, thanks very much, but, you know, there's people that are inspiring more people than what I am.
After everything he's been through, the ups and downs experienced by most golfers on the PGA Tour are a walk in the park for Jarrod. Regardless of what happens on the golf course, just being on tour in 2015 and beyond will mark a huge accomplishment, no matter how many birdies and bogeys he makes.
My perspective is now, mate, any day on the golf course, whether it's good or bad, is better than a good day in hospital. So, you know, people say it about their work and things like that, but I've seen some things in hospital that you never want to see and you never wish on anybody. So, you know, just to be out playing golf, mate, it's a very special thing for me, and I cherish every day I can play golf.